Breakfast Television at 11 after 7. Thanks for starting your morning with us. Lisa Rumble from the Winnipeg Humane Society joining us with Lester, who is currently up for adoption at the Humane Society.
He is.
First, let's start with this handsome guy. Tell us a little bit about him.
He is 7 months old.
Aww.
And he is just adorable. He's kind of a purring machine. Doesn't take, once you pick him up, doesn't take him long to get started purring.
And look at his amazing collar. He's wearing it quite happily.
He is. He's doing okay.
Who thought? Who knew a cat would wear a collar like that? He looks so, so great. And for a cat this cute, it's hard to believe that people might think that he's bad luck.
I know, it's a weird superstition that started in the Middle Ages in Europe and kind of came to America with the Salem witch hunts, that they're somehow associated with witches, but people in the know it's not the truth.
Not the truth at all. So this Halloween, don't be scared of black cats.
No, no.
They are not bad luck. They are lovely and they need a home just like every other cat. But why do you think it is that black cats and black dogs are always the last to be adopted?
Well, there's some theories out there that say that because there is no contrast in their face, so when you walk by quickly and you just see all black, you don't get that same sort of personality that you might get when there's more contrast between like what lighter and darker things on their face, and so it's easier to get more information about their... But not that they don't have a lot of personality, it just takes a little bit, a second glance to
That's
see their
right.
personality.
Just look a little bit harder and you'll see such lovely, lovely creatures with beautiful black fur like Lester.
Yes.
Here, shiny, shiny black. Okay, let's talk about some safety tips for Halloween tomorrow,
mm-hmm.
whether you have a cat or a dog, a few things to keep in mind when trick-or-treaters
yes.
are coming around.
Absolutely. The most important thing, I think, is to have some ID on your pet. Even if your cat doesn't normally wear a collar, maybe have a collar with a little tag on it, because door is going to be opening and closing a whole lot tomorrow night.
Yes.
So they could slip out without anybody knowing by accident. So it's really important to have their ID on them. Having a microchip as well is also a great way to make sure that your pet can get home to you.
And even eliminating the issue at all, maybe keeping them in a separate room is a
yes,
good idea?
Yes, even that is an even better idea. It's a pretty stressful night with people coming and going, all sorts of sounds and weird looking people and that
That's
sort
right.
of thing.
We know how some dogs respond to mascots, never mind all the zombies that
yes.
are going to come into the door.
Yes, exactly. So having them just tucked away in a separate room for the night with maybe, you know, if it's your dog, maybe with a nice bone or something that
yes.
he enjoys and
nice
and
Halloween treat.
Exactly, he gets a Halloween treat too.
And let's talk about costumes, because this is so cute on Lester here. Now this is from the gift shop?
This is from the Humane Society gift shop, that's right. We have all sorts of ones for cats and dogs.
I've never seen a cat dressed up. It's so cute.
Yeah, he's pretty in the season, I guess. Yeah. The one thing that you want to remember with costumes is it can be pretty stressful for some animals. So it's a good thing to kind of do some trial runs with their costume before Halloween night.
Okay.
That way they can get a little bit used to it. Halloween night's going to be stressful in all sorts of
As
other
is.
Ways. So you don't want to add extra stress on by having this costume on them too.
Right. And make sure you're not blocking their nose or their ears
That's
or
right.
their eyes.
That's right. Let them have all their senses to deal with all the goings on. And you also want to make sure that it, like for instance, this costume here has a lot of things that are really interesting and fun that he might want to chew on.
Yeah.
So you want to make sure that you keep them supervised so that they don't hurt themselves.
Lester, I feel like you're going to find a home real fast. You are too cute for words. Thank you so much, Lisa. You can find him and many other black cats.
Yes, many others.
And black dogs at the Winnipeg Humane Society, 45 Hurst Way. And now you know, not bad luck, just
no.
a cute, cute animal. I will check in with Jenna.